Hello there.
General Kenobi.
No, I'm the Hacksmith, and my team and I are on the quest to build the world's first fully contained, cordless, door-melting, flesh-cauterizing, blaster-bolt-deflecting lightsaber. And I think we're getting close. This is our fifth-generation lightsaber, the hottest and most compact lightsaber we've ever made. The internals are small enough to fit our technology into pretty much any replica hilt, while still being able to cut through steel. We've even figured out how to turn the blade red. And with these quick connects, you can quickly attach it to our compact power supply worn on the hip. We're gonna show you how we made this and then make some dreams come true by letting fans try it out themselves. And spoiler alert, we have a surprise for them that you don't wanna miss.
Oh, come on now.
This is like the coolest thing ever.
But let's rewind a little bit before we show you how we made this. Our eyes lit up with fascination for the first time back in 1976 when we saw the first laser sword on the big screen. But as incredible as it was just special effects. There was no such thing as a lightsaber, but luckily that didn't stop companies from attempting to make it real. And thus, the first toy lightsabers were created, and they got better and better and better. But how close are we to a real life darn tootin' lightsaber? I decided to grade the current lightsabers built to date on a graph, judging them on criteria such as retractability, cutting ability, temperature, color, sound, blade length, swing ability, and more. And as you can see, we're getting pretty close. If this line of best fit is any indication, it looks like we might have a real world's first lightsaber, just like the movies, by the year 2030. But don't quote me on that. I do think our proto lightsaber is still the closest thing to the movies. It sounds like a lightsaber, it looks like a lightsaber, and it even cuts like a lightsaber. But I know it could be better. Well, step one is to shrink down our current design. A lot. I wrote Bogdan a blank check 2 years ago to continue researching this. And this is what he's come up with.
Ever since the development of our plasma-based protosaber almost 2 years ago, we've been doing non-stop research and development to make this system smaller, lighter, and more reliable. In fact, we even got to show off our progress to Mr. Beast, and we almost ruined his video.
Wait, what? All right.
Make sure you check it out. We've rethought the entire design from the ground up, from the fuel system to the ignition system, and the electronics have all been optimized to be smaller, lighter, and easier to use. In fact, the system is so small and light that it can fit on your hip now, instead of this giant heavy backpack. And it's easy enough for a five-year-old to use. All that's left now is to take all this and turn it into a lightsaber. The lightsaber consists of three components: the hilt, the electronics, and the power pack. I'm gonna get Charles started on the electronics while I work on the hilt. I need to fit all of this into here, and there's not much room to work with. The plumbing, valves, and connections have all been sized down, but to make them work together, I need to make a custom manifold. To do that, I used our lathe and Tormach 1100 MX CNC machine to fabricate all the parts. Then I measured and cut the copper tubing to length to get ready for final assembly. After a quick polish and clean, I was ready to solder all the parts together. This process is relatively simple. I cover the joints in flux, heat them up with a blowtorch, and add just the right amount of solder to guarantee an airtight seal. For the final assembly, all I have to do is bend the copper tubes to the right shape and install the needle valves. After soldering on the flange and cutting off the excess tube, we can lap the surface to make sure it's perfectly flat. And then we're ready to attach our Glass Torch Technologies Mirage nozzle. This right here is what makes the magic happen. I redesigned the tether to be smaller and more flexible, and also added my favorite feature, Quick Connects. They'll allow us to attach, remove, and switch out the handle in a matter of seconds.
I don't have time to talk about your new game, James. I'm trying to finish the lightsaber.
What if I told you there's a character named Saber who has a lightsaber in this game? It's an epic skin called Force Warrior.
What even is this game?
It's an idle RPG called Mobile Legends Adventure. Whenever I need a short break, I'm playing this game. It's a game where I can leave the hard work to my heroes. And there's over 100 heroes with unique skills and amazing weapons that will be fun to replicate in a future video. And there's a special island party event going on right now.
I do like to party.
You've all been invited, and the rewards for participating are massive. There'll be 4 new summer skins as well, so be sure to grab them before the party ends. Join the island party now to get a total of 100 free summons and a ton of diamonds. Remember to use the bonus code here to redeem those gifts. Click the link in the description for a chance to get those prizes. This is the time for you to start your Mobile Legends adventure. Download it now for iOS or Android and start anytime, anywhere. Adventure awaits.
To get the lightsaber effect that we're looking for, we need to precisely tune how much oxygen and fuel goes into the lightsaber nozzle. This will make sure that we can get the longest blade possible and have the highest heat output. All that's left is to put this into the handle.
Bogdan's asked me to whip up the electronics for our new lightsaber. There's going to be 2 printed circuit boards, one in the grip and one in the power pack. To design those PCBs, we're going to be using Altium Design. Let's do it. If you want a free trial of Altium Designer, check out our link in the description below. Now that the designs are done, we can source the parts through Octopart, and we can get the boards ordered through JLC PCB, the fast and cheap PCB manufacturing service. With these PCBs, we can implement sound effects, auto ignition, and valve control. This should really make the lightsaber come to life. To see the full schematic diagram, check out the project on maker.io, link in the description below. It's all soldered up and wired in. Let's see if it works. Yes. All right, let's see if we get lightsaber noises. All righty. That's working a treat.
For my lightsaber build, I'm going to choose the iconic Darth Vader saber.
And all those fully installed. Connectors are in. Handles together. Next up, aux connector. Now I get the fun job of trying to shove this in there.
Now that I have the lightsaber hilt fully finished, and Charles put together and tested the circuit board, it's time to work on the power pack. I have Chris, our new co-op from the University of Waterloo, who's designed the power pack components. Let's put it together. We've made a bunch of upgrades to our power pack, including a swappable battery, a smaller speaker, quick connects, much cheaper valves, and a fuel heater to ensure consistent performance. All this adds up to a power pack that's way smaller, lighter, and more visually appealing. There we go. There's our power pack. Just need to add the power switch to make it a power
pack. And also the power. That would also help. Right now it's just a pack.
That's our power pack. Should we get our first test? Just like that.
Hopefully. Get it. Oh, okay.
Sounding pretty good, pretty good. All right. You ready?
Yeah.
And it doesn't
work. Oh, that's not expected.
It's like, you need a lightsaber? Turn the oxygen on.
We forgot the oxygen.
Yes!
Dude, that's a full lightsaber.
Off. Okay. On. Charles! What was that?
What is going on?
Does I think the battery's low.
Oh.
I think that's the battery low alarm.
Here, can you give me the dead one?
Alright, we got a new battery in there. Let's give this another test. This thing is freaking awesome.
Oh my goodness.
I cannot wait to show this to everyone else.
And we have a design that's super compact and mounts right onto the hip.
It's awesome. There we go.
Bogdan and Chris did a fantastic job finishing up the Darth Vader lightsaber. I mean, look at the detail on this thing. And the power pack can fit on your hip now. Let's light it up. Now there's just one problem. It's blue. To turn our lightsaber blade red, we're gonna have to turn to chemistry. We have this product called Dragon's Breath, and it's actually a chemical that changes the color of flame to red. And as you can see, using my trusty mini saber, see, it turns the blue flame a nice bright red. We tried using this with our bigger flame on the lightsaber, and it didn't quite work. So we're actually gonna have to mix this with a bit of strontium chloride, which is the chemical in flares that give them that red, bright color. Now we have our strontium-enriched dragon's breath. Let's see if it works. So the neat thing with this is, since it's a paste, I can literally just take a fingerful and actually just apply it around the cowling of our lightsaber. Now, if any luck, when we turn this on, we'll have a nice red blade worthy of Vader himself. Woo! Now that's a bright red flame. That's really bright. It hurts to look at. Look at that. Oh, my eyes. Now, you may have noticed that the lightsaber blade didn't seem quite as long as it has been in other videos. And that's because, since this is a flame saber, sometimes the length does vary a lot based on even the airflow in the room. It also means you can't really swing the lightsaber super fast. But those are things that we're working on for our next revision of the lightsaber, so don't you worry.
Hey guys!
This is amazing.
Welcome to Hacksmith Industries.
Instead of a regular test where we try out the lightsaber, we decided to invite you guys, our subscribers, into Hacksmith Industries to try it out yourself. And we told you to bring your costumes. But what they don't know is that Ian's dressed up as Darth Vader and is hiding just around the corner. Let's see how they react to a Sith Lord appearing behind them.
All right, well, we're gonna get you to summon your lightsaber.
It's unwise to lower your defenses.
Oh no.
What is that?
Your battery's low. Whoops.
All right. What happened, Darth Vader?
Battery died.
Summon it.
Oh, shut up. That's crazy.
Now, that is the Darth Vader saber, but unfortunately, you're not Darth Vader, so you can't use that one. But lucky for you, we've got a real working Kenobi lightsaber.
Perfect. Woo!
Oh my gosh, okay. Come on, baby.
Yeah!
Hey, Lala.
This is like the coolest thing ever.
That's crazy.
The heat coming off of this is amazing.
Let me help you.
Do you feel the heat coming off of it?
Oh yeah, my hand is like getting toasty. It's like the rebels, burn them down.
This is amazing. Lightsaber.
Wow, this is a little bit hot.
All right, we're gonna get you to cut something.
Oh, come on now.
Oh, that's crazy. That's crazy. This is unbelievable. We're getting a mini saber at the store, I'm telling you that much.
Yeah!
It's a lobotomy.
Oh my gosh. How does that feel?
This is epic.
And we're through! Woo! Awesome.
That is cool.
Would you like to burn something?
Oh yeah.
The dark side is more powerful.
I know. I want to join it.
Yes!
That's marshmallows for you, buddy.
There you go. I'll die.
I don't think it's toasty enough. Hacksmith does score.
Prepare to meet your destiny. Are you prepared to duel? Prepare to meet your destiny.
Oh, hey, baby.
stepping on my cape.
Scary.
This thing is so cool, oh my god.
Prepare to meet your destiny, Obi-Wan. Your cape looks flammable. Are you ready to join the dark side?
Let me think about it.
I need cookies.
That's a really good offer. I don't know. Sure. Here, what do you say? That's a good idea.
If you want to be in our next Hacksmith video, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram, because that's where we usually post updates about events happening right here. You can also sign up for our newsletter at hacksmith.store to learn about all of our new product launches and invites to our events. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.